Many classrooms are going completely paperless by using OneNote, and teachers, students, and even parents are loving it. Students have access to all materials and information at their fingertips at all times, with no heavy backpacks or misplaced work. Now is the time to go back and ensure that all your materials are accessible for all your students. We are going to look at ways to make your existing content accessible without having to recreate everything. I have a OneNote notebook that I use for a marine mammal unit on orca whales. It contains great resources, documents, and pictures, but currently they are not accessible for all my students. My notebook is broken down into different sections, and I will need to go through every page to ensure that all my students can access the materials. My first page has pictures and tables that give great information, but aren't accessible. The first thing that I did was to clean up the page. I put all the pictures and text in a logical order vertically. This allowed me to make the pictures larger and have less clutter on the page. It also allowed me to ensure the reading order for a screen reader. First, let's look at the pictures of the orca and its skeleton. I changed the URL to descriptive text for the picture to say that it is a link to the Bing picture of the orca whale body parts. This is important because a screen reader will read every character in the URL, and that is time-consuming and not effective. Next, I see that there are pictures on the page. Adding alt text to the pictures allow a screen reader to announce information about the picture, not just that it is a picture. I right-clicked on the picture and selected alt text. The description of the picture is already there. Note that some screen readers only read out the description, so it is important to fill this in. For images with text in them, OneNote can automatically recognize the text and suggest this as alt text. The description of the picture is great, so the user can know what the picture is and gain some meaningful information. There are ways to take that a step further. I added an audio file with me describing exactly what is going on in the picture, describing all the body parts, including color. This is a great way to take a picture meaningful to a user who is either blind, visually impaired, or has a print disability. This page also has a list of web addresses. To make each link more meaningful, I'm going to change the link to the descriptive text instead of the URL. For example, for the first link, I right-click and select Edit Link, and I change the text to display to American Cetacean Society Fact Sheet. Below the link to the web pages are links to listen to orcas in Alaska vocalizing. There are three links to show variety in the sounds. From a user perspective, they all look almost the same because the web address is only different by one number. This can be frustrating because unless you remember exactly which one you listen to, you might keep repeating or skipping links. To solve this problem, I can change the descriptive text to better describe what the link is about. In this case, I labeled each one as Recording 1, 2, and 3, making it much easier to distinguish between each link. Finally, on this page, we have a table that is nested and doesn't have a header row. To fix this, I take out the nested table, or table inside a table, and put the data into the one cell. In my notebook in the biology section on the population page, I have inserted a document that was created in Word. I originally inserted it onto the page as a printout. The problem is that it looks like a picture to a screen reading program. It is so important to remember to also insert the original document link as well as the printout. This allows the user to open it in Word or Excel and use the screen reader and access information. This document also includes charts and graphs, so remember to include alt text in the original document as well. Once you have completed going through your document, or even after each page, run the accessibility checker to ensure that all components of your OneNote notebook are accessible for all your users. OneNote is such a fantastic way to keep all of your lessons organized. Many classrooms have gone completely paperless. Those teachers love the reduction of all that physical paper clutter.